kind of one at a time. I know your situations are different, but starting with you, Kalija, you could have gone into the draft. You didn't. Why particularly for your situation did you think you wanted to come back?
I thought it was important for me to, first of all, chase a degree. Anna has a great degree. Just having that piece of paper is a big deal. I feel like I still have things to accomplish on the field. Want to break that touchdown like that Joe Matthew hold. He's a good guy, but I need that from him. And you know, just another year with my brothers. It's good.
Pink, why are you coming back?
For me, it was a lot about graduating. You know, if I was declared, I was thinking about doing my job now. You know, just focusing strictly on combine. But now that I'm here, I'm able to give my full effort towards graduating in December. And then also, I have a couple of individual goals that I really didn't come close to getting this season. I had an okay season. But the goals that I set for myself, I didn't really accomplish. And then the team goals, we accomplished one or two, but there's still a lot out there for us that we're really excited to go get.
Keyshawn, you could have taken this bowl. It's pretty good. Why not leave on that?
One is I'm already at Vanderbilt, so I might as well stay and get the diploma while I'm here. And then another one, just like on the field stuff, still got a lot to prove. And then it's also another year as a team to be better. So,
Keyshawn, how many people after the bowl game said something like that to you? Like, that's a perfect way to go out. I mean, did you hear that a lot?
For us staying in school, or
like, no, to leave after a big game like that, just say that's it. I'm done. I'm moving on.
Well, I heard it a lot right after the game. The game really wasn't going to determine my situation. My situation more for what's the best thing for my family. And so with me, one of the reasons I stayed was to get what I deserve as far as like what I'm at the next level. So I still felt like there was stuff for me to prove on this level to get what I want to be on the next level.
Starting with you, Kalija, working across, I'm sure you talked to him, you will be able to leave. What kind of feedback were you getting on where you could have gone in the draft?
Anywhere from 3 to 5. And to me, I feel strongly that I can do a little bit better than that. At the end of the day, it's the same next season. I'm going to roll it. And I'll take it where it is. And then, you know, I'll take the opportunity. But, you know, good feedback, good things to work on, improve upon this offseason. And I'm looking forward to get better.
Based on what everybody told me, from agents to NFL personnel, I was going anywhere from 2 to 4. And then some people had it on the high end, some people had it on the low end. So I just kind of took from that that I'd probably be a third round pick. And that wasn't, it wasn't good enough for me, obviously. So, I'd like to, instead of in a draft class with like 20 dudes that are going to draft, and I might be in the top 5 guys, maybe next year I'll definitely be 1, 2, 3.
My grades was from anywhere from 3rd to 7th. So I feel like I'm better than a 3rd to 7th round running back. So that's a way to come in and getting what I deserve. Feeling like I can get more money, staying the next year, also with the diploma. So it's a win-win.
Kalija, you had a good rapport, obviously, with Kyle. How much did you weigh the fact that he's not going to be here next year and it's a quarterback you might not be as familiar with?
Honestly, I thought about it, but it came and went pretty fast. The guys that I feel like I have the faith in the guys that are coming in. I've played with dudes. I know we got some younger guys coming in, transfer that he's ready to ball. Like you said, Kyle's my guy. He's always going to be my guy. And I've really seen these 3 years playing with him. They've really been a blessing. He's taught a lot. He's taught me a lot about the game of football and about life in general. He's a great guy to be around. And first and foremost, I'm excited to see what he can do going forward, whether it be football or, you know, in the private sector. But, you know, life goes on, and the show must go on.
Did you guys all three inform Coach Mason at the same time, or was it individual?
I think I said it a little earlier. I put like a little Instagram caption out, some corny. But and then I just kind of sat back and like, and I'm happy these guys came back. And, you know, I'm excited to see what we can do going forward.
How has Coach been with you guys through this process? Kind of like let you guys figure it out and come back if you want, or support you if whatever decision you made?
I feel like Coach Mason has, like, well, me individually, he has sat down with me, gave me everything, like the rundown of stuff I didn't know about the league, as far as like the money situation, the draft grade. You can get this draft grade, but you might end up getting drafted here. So this is just small stuff I didn't know about that as a college student just trying to get to the league to get some money, you're not really thinking about. So sitting down with him, family, I feel like my best decision was to stay. So.
Jared, with a new quarterback next year, how much do you think you three in particular will help that person?
About as much as they need, you know. I mean, we got the best running back in the SEC, if not the country. Best receiver in the SEC, if not the country. You know,
best tight end.
Not the country. And so, I mean, regardless of who's playing, whether it's Riley Deuce or Jamil or Allen or Mo, I mean, we've got guys we've got faith in, you know. So whoever we put out there, what is August 31st against Georgia, they'll be ready to go. They'll be ready to play, and we'll be ready to support them.
Keyshawn, for you and anybody else who wants to add in this, when you go through the process of seeing if you're going to declare or if you're going to come back, do you think about the fact that there could be something that happens with the injury next season? I mean, does that come into play at all when you're speaking to the people that are talking with you about the decision making?
Well, yes, it does come into play. But I feel like I've been playing this game football so long. One next year, I should be straight. I don't know. But I'm really not really too worried about injuries. I feel like I play the game safe enough, mm-hmm. where I'm not taking like crazy shots, especially like to my body, lower legs or anything. So I feel like I should be good.
And you guys, I mean, is that
wrong? For me, it didn't really weigh on the decision a whole lot. Just based strictly on if worst case scenario I did get injured, I'd probably go in the same range level this mm-hmm. year. So, and then if I don't have this, if just the same year that I had this year, I'd raise my start just because there's nobody else that has this type of production over the type of, you know, 2 or 3 years.
Well, just starting with you and working across again, how much, obviously, these two guys returning makes things easier for you, and I think any one of you could say stuff for the others. How much did you guys talk to each other? How much did the fact that the other two guys came back influence what you were?
But like I said, I made my decision kind of early. I guess I kind of jumped in. But when Jerry and then Pink said they were coming back, Jerry and Keith said they were coming back, I was ecstatic because I just know what type of players these guys are, what type of respect they're going from other teams, whether it be people loading the box to stop Keith, that helped me, and seeing on coverage, people putting a linebacker and safety over the top of Jared to take him out of the game plan. You know, it all works together. And I think it's gonna, like you said, it's gonna help all three of us just be on the same field for another year and then being that much better this year.
Same for you.
Yeah. Can you repeat?
How much did it impact your decision that these two guys were coming back, and how much did you guys talk to each other?
Well, like you said, he went pretty early, so I knew he was coming back, and I texted him up there just, you know, check base. See what he was doing, see what he was thinking. And midway through, it became pretty clear that he was probably leaning towards coming back. I kind of checked my situation a little bit harder and looked a little bit differently at it. And I honestly didn't know. Whenever I sent out the Twitter thing, I knew at 10:30 the night before what I was doing. I didn't know before.
Keyshawn? Like I said, Kay was the first one who committed. It's basically the same thing. He was the first one to announce that he was staying. Like, I want to say right after the UT game or something like that. But, like, my process was slow. Jerry's process was slow. But me and him was keeping in contact a lot, talking about what rounds we'll go, our decision, why I hit it, as far as, like, guys returning, guys leaving. We were just keeping each other any interest above, like, almost like above for each other. So, like, we're going to work out to benefit each other.
For all three of you, do you feel like you have a good kind of leadership opportunity with a new offensive coordinator coming in to kind of guide some of the younger players in this offense?
I think that was going to come naturally just by being older. I mean, these guys have been on the team longer than me. Well, Dre's been on the team longer than me, and Key's just Key, so people follow him. But we have a good opportunity, especially on the offensive side of the ball, with us three just, you know, being a core, and then, you know, allowing people to gravitate around that core so that we can work towards the same goals. And then on the team, the total team in general, I feel like we all have different personalities, but we all have connections with our teammates so that we can form a close bond, we can stick together when things get hard, and we can push through the long season.
Yeah, just for me personally, my leadership would have to come off of the way I play and then how long I've been here. Strictly because I'm not a guy that's going to like get up in front of the team and yell rah-rah before the game. And then I'm only 21. There's people looking great under me and two women that are still like older than me. So, like, I'm a young guy still. And then just the way I play, I think it's who I am, you know. So people will follow me based off of how I play because they see who I am in the truest and easiest fashion.
I feel like just with us three coming back, it takes a lot of pressure off like the younger guys. That was like playing them as much because when you have so much playing time under our belt, it's less stressful for them guys because we can step up in them big situations. And I feel like we'll be good.
How fun has it been to have Key the addition this past season, and now he's coming back and you guys are all coming back. I mean, it's gotta be fun to already just be thinking about the season.
That's
the mom. It's just people you see him on TV and it's electrifying, it's exciting. Then you get around and it's just.
Does he have some positive views?
It's always funny. It's always different things. You just never know what you're gonna get. But you always know what you're gonna get because it's always high and great. But you never know what you're gonna get. If that makes sense. But you know, I'm looking forward to the season. I think it's going to be great.
For you guys, have seen Key showing up practice all through last season. Was there anything in that bowl game that you saw that still sort of made you, you know, scrub your eyes a little bit?
I was on the sideline a lot for the Baylor game, and I was like, hey, when he broke the first one, I was like, there he is. When he did the second one, I was like, something's spinning in his head, gear spinning. And then when he did the last one, I'm like, oh, his raps go sit down. Anybody trying to tackle him, it's not gonna happen. He's getting in his mode, and it's great to watch.
One or two more questions.
Keith, it took half the year or so for you to sort of become the man in that running back group, at least in terms of playing time. How different is it gonna be coming into this season, knowing you're going to be getting the ball from game one probably more than anybody?
It's a good feeling just to have that load on my back, to be able to carry this team along with these guys to a better season than we had last year. Not as much pressure because I got these two guys back that would open up the box and try to stop Pinkney and K. So it's a win-win situation.
You guys going to signature, like a nickname this season? I mean, it's like three up here. Like,
It's going. But you can't give yourself a nickname.
Somebody else has got it. Okay.
If it comes naturally, that's one thing.
Okay.
Let's focus on one though.
Shout out to Ron James.
You guys good?
Jared, what inspired your tweet coming back with the Wolf of Wall Street reference?
Shout out to Justin School and Ian Pfeiffer. They introduced me to that movie my freshman year, and I've loved it ever since. You know, and I love Leonardo DiCaprio. I'm a huge Leo fan. So, I mean, I love the movie. The situation was perfect. Everybody texted me, was in the comments, and that was awesome. It was legendary. Tweet of the year. But yeah, that's really all of us.
Thanks, guys.